Welcome back. My name is Mulligan and this is Factorio. Last time I decided to make this first automation redo it totally. Because after we are done with this automation, we have to get the second automation going, which will be a pain, which we'll research right now. We could research engines. Better electronic distribution, advanced material processing. We can get some optics. Doesn't cost much. So what I want to do is, okay, so we are starting outside this time around. So we don't have to work around those energy poles. They are not connected anymore. There we go. Better. So we are free from them. Bam. This is what will produce iron gear wheels. And this is going to be output. And down a line, which will be split. Bam. Which will be split again. These are two outputs, and bam. Let's see. So they will be split, they will be split. Perfect. We have four outputs, which will allow us to get two more of these if we have the materials, which mainly uses more iron plates. Bam. Okay, three. Now, we need four of these. And we need... We could. Let's do it differently. Yeah. Like this. Seems good. So the first two are going down. Bap, 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 bap. They're getting pulled up. Hello. Pushed in the production. And then we could put this. We don't really need to because of another thing. But this will just go over here and this side will just go over here. We put bam and bam. And here we can have this production going. Bam, 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 bam. Okay. Now, we need to first get an input over here. We need our iron plates. Bam, iron plates. We can put 100 in here. Now we need a similar system for this side. I will do it a little bit different. Yeah, so we need a splitter here, a splitter here, a splitter here, input. Okay. We don't need two, we only need one. This is our copper input. Okay, so it would be better for the other side. Meh. We need more. 1, 2, 3, 4. First input. Second input. Bam, bam. And I just have to get those rolling around. Now follow like a little snake. Leave one space between. Bam. Looking good. Doesn't help me with the end result, but okay. So now we have this production. Now, one problem, I can't extract this way. If I... Yeah. If I do it like I wanted before... Remove those. And put them up here. Then we should be able to have outputs. There we go. Remove this. Put this over here. Put this one. Nope. Bam. Music seems a little bit too low. Let's hope this helps. Okay. You are going down here. Bap, bap. One. And you are going down here. Okay. Now we take two long-handed inserter. One. Two. We take two normal inserter. Bam. And bam. Okay. Something along those lines. I don't really want that. You are putting your stuff over here. Okay. This goes around. Bam, bam, bam. We need more. Boop. 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 Let's go around, get some coal going, and get our plates. We need a couple copper, a couple iron plates. Fill all your bellies with coal. And all your bellies with delicious coal. Until I'm ready to give you other stuff. Okay. We don't really have any... we can get some walls. Really easy research. Okay, so we have this. Okay. Bam, bam, bam. We don't have enough. Two of these. Get a chest. Okay, walls are done. Next part. Everything needs science pack 2. So let's go for the furnace right off the bat. There we go. Now, this will be down. Okay. Can remove you to get the result I want. Mop. Okay, now we have to get power going. Okay, so power over here. Power. Let's see. Okay, every side gets one copper plate. And then the other side gets a copper plate. Perfect. Exactly how I wanted it to happen. We can check this side too. How is it going? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, every side gets 1. So we have an equal division of materials, which is good. We are now getting power everywhere. Now the only thing is the output. Now. Okay, perfect. So the inserter always puts the conveyor belt has two spots, inside and outside. So something close to the body and one outside. And the inserter always packs the stuff outside the body. This is wrong way around. Bad. No wonder these are... Okay, this is working. As you see, this inserter puts this outside to the left. And this this conveyor belt is just putting it in the inside. So we have both sides being filled with science packs. If we run into the problem that we produce too much, we have an equal division of both sides being filled. Unless the same can't be said here, because we have only one side being filled here, which is a little bit problematic if we get too many materials over there. Okay, so refilling science pack 1, getting more iron plates, getting more copper plates. Now the nice job of getting the second science pack automation going is commencing. This will be a pain. Okay, we needed 6. We needed at least 1, 2. Transport belt, inserter, electronic circuits. Okay, everything else is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's hope this works, as this is enough. If not, we can always make more. We need a bunch of inserter. Probably 10. So this is working. And the good thing about doing it per splitter instead of what I had before is that everyone gets the same resource. So if one side is a little bit slower, no problem. It's not like this one is getting filled with copper. No. It is exactly like this. No. We have one iron gear here, one copper plate here. Because the splitter is not is differently configured on both sides. Yes, yeah. Because the splitter here is working off the other side. So let's do this. Bam, now both sides should be the same. Can always try that. Come on. By just doing another run. 50 and 25. Bam. Okay. This is going. Coal? Are we? No, we. Okay, now there's coal lying right there. Good. Okay, next production. We have to begin. So, we have two sides, one for the transport bed and one for the inserter. Both sides need iron gears. Okay. This is the last thing we need. We need to get the electronic circuits going first. So, we need copper cable. Does the other side need copper? No, only iron plates. So we only have one output for copper. It's going straight into assembly line, produce copper cable, which should and is only used for an electronic circuit. So straight going into a little box as filter, as buffer, and this goes straight into electronic circuits, which need stupid iron plates. Okay, so we have inserter, need 4 iron plates, and a transport bed, which needs 3. Now, aside from the iron gear wheels, we need 1 iron plate for our transport beds, 1 for inserter, and 1 for the electronic circuit. So 2-to-1 is the ratio. Okay, we need a couple more splitter, more transport beds. Okay, we are getting production over there. We are producing, we need a bunch of stuff for the splitter. Okay, so this is our iron output. Bam. Going straight into a conveyor belt, which is getting split and split. Other way around. Bam. Now, what I'm going to do is, on which side are they splitting the stuff? To the right or left? To the right. So to the left if you are behind. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to I'm going to fuse 2 sides, which means 2 sides, this is 2 and this is 1. This is for our conveyor belt, this is for our inserter. Bam. Now we need 4. We need 1 iron plate for the inserter. We need 1 for the electronic circuits and 2. We need an iron gear wheel. Yes, 2 for the iron gear wheel. So that is not in this, which means we only need 2. We don't even need to merge those. We can just go around and put iron plates in here. Bam, we now have electronic circuits, which we can remove. Bam, this is getting into production. Then we have the problem of iron gear wheels. So both sides need iron gear wheels. Let's see. I need 2 iron gear wheels, which means I need 7 plates. Okay, 7 plates. Right, I need, god damn it. I produced 2 transport beds, I forgot. So I have to count this double, I need 8. This is not going to work. Okay, let's go and let's see again. Okay, so we need 2 per inserter iron plates, removing the iron gear wheel out of the equation, and 1 for the transport bay. Now we need twice as much for the inserter because we need to produce 2. And only 1 transport bed, which means we need 4 plates for the inserter and 1 for the transport bed. Now the iron gear wheel needs 2 plates to produce 1 iron gear wheel, which we need then to split. Okay. We need to produce. You need to get 6 plates rolling. As 6 plates to the iron gear wheels. And then the rest. Okay. So the ratio is 1 transport bed, 6 for the iron gear wheels, and 4 for the inserter. 1, 4, 6. So we have 11. How do I split this crap? 1, 4, and 6. Because the splitter is splitting twice. So what I can do is do this. So now we have 4. We can split those parts. We need maybe more splitter. We can always fuse them if needed. We have 4. Okay. So what we can do? 1. This is not enough splitting going on. Okay, not enough splitting. 2. Nah, this is not going to work. This is harder than I thought to just do with splitter. I would need to split again here, again down here. And now I have splitted all the stuff into 8. 8 times. Okay. Okay, 8 times. We could fuse now. We could fuse 4, 3, and 1. That is not enough. We need 6, 4, and 1. 6, 4, and 1. 11 is a shit number. What I could do, I could have 1 transport bay. This here. Bep, 1. I could merge those 3 together. And have those 4 together for the... Yeah, I could. Which means I don't need to split this. If I have those together. I could just put those together, bam. And here I could put those together. Bam. Yes, it would work, but too many iron plates would go to the transport bed, which is a problem, which I could live with. Okay, it seems I'm not able to have the automation here right now, at least not perfect. Perfect is a strong word. Not efficient as I wanted. Not like here. Those should be. No, they still have overlap. Okay. Sure. You do you. Okay. So I'm just going to get my iron gear production this is what needs most of the stuff. So you are producing iron gear wheels, which is at least something I can split. Because we need two for... We need one. Is this even splitting correct? Not really. This is 50%, 25%, 12%. This is 60%. No, it's okay. Bam. So this is transport bed. This is our production. Let's find out. Okay. You are the wrong guy. Bam. You are making inserter. Bam. And input. Bap. We need to get you here. Bap, bap, bap. Bap. Okay, we have you here. We should make this a different way. Okay. Okay. How do I want to... On this side? Sure. No. Yes. Whatever. Doesn't really matter. We are removing this two spaces away. This is not even enough. Okay. Let's move it. 1, 2, 3, 4. This seems like a good number. What am I doing? Okay, this was the way I want to do it. There we go. Now, the iron plates go around here and get fed up into the iron gear wheels. They're getting produced as much as they are needed. And the rest we will just move up to where it's needed. As example, we're going to get a long hand guy. Sure. Seems good. Bam. So he's pulling stuff over here, which is going into the inserter production. And all the stuff that is going through is going into the conveyor belt production. There we go. Get more of these, get more of these, and we need two of the, we only need one. One more. Okay. Pull this out and this. Get this going. If I put this and there is stuff, let's get moved to the right, I believe. So the best way is to do this. Bam. Bam. And then down here. For future. Increase. There we go. And those should make those green vials, which are getting put down here and into a box. Now, is that working? I have no idea. It is definitely not efficient. That I am certain. There we go. Getting 50 more. Bam, 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 bam. Let's go fill up more furnaces. And then we are going to get a test run of our new production. I probably have to get those signal things later on in the research tree to make this more realistic. I did it once. It did take a while to comprehend, and I have to do it again, which is a little bit of a bummer. What we should do is get another furnace, have it here, pump out some steel. How much steel do I need? 8. Okay, let's see if we get electricity everywhere. Because of the low range of these things, we have to fill everything with those guys. Okay. 300 and 200. Okay, our iron gears are getting reduced. The production is pretty fast. Which means that all the rest is not getting anything. Which is not a problem because the iron gear can't produce endlessly. They don't have a buffer. But a fast inserter is going to increase production a lot. This should make these things. And you are not looking in the right direction. Okay, production, are you producing? No. I don't have any production. Yep. Not a problem fixing that on the fly. Why not get some more of these? Bap. There we go. Perfect, like I wanted. So we have on the bottom side up here. Bottom we have transport beds, on the top we have inserter. Which means we only need one transport bay to supply everything on the line. We can just, if we want, and this production line down here is sufficient enough, we can just add more Science Pack 2 assembly lines and expand our production a lot. Okay, we can make our first steel chest, which is going to replace our wooden chest, which allows a lot more stuff to be placed inside. But okay, I will end this episode here. Next episode, we will see if we can get some more production. We will see where the problem lies, what we need to produce more of. And after that, we will research more stuff and maybe get the electronic furnace. So stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe, share, like, and comment. And as always, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.